Hi, my name is Courtney. I'm a technician here at Dove Lewis. Today I'm going to go over taping of IV catheters in patients. So as you can see, we have an IV catheter placed for this patient. The first thing we want to do for taping is make sure that it's clean and dry in this area. So if there's any blood around, I would take some gauze. You know, some have really good blood pressure. I've wiggled, and so I would get maybe a little bit of peroxide on some gauze, clean it up, and then follow it up with a dry piece of gauze to dry it off. His is actually pretty clean. He's been a very good patient for this. So our first piece of tape is we tear down the top. So we tear it halfway this way, and then we fold down one side. Left hand, I use keep the left hand up. Right hand, you'll keep the right hand side up. And we always like to do a little tab. It's called a courtesy tab. This will be your best friend when you have to retape an IV catheter. All right, so I'm gonna lift up the IV catheter, place this piece underneath, sticky side up. And then I'm going to stick the tape to itself and myself. All right. So then I'm going to wrap it around the patient. I don't want to put it too tight because I don't want to cut off circulation and give him a fat paw. So what I do is I pull it taut down here and then I lay it gently over the top. Now some patients that are super dehydrated, you may still see that they get fat paw because once they get rehydrated, their tissues kind of enlarge, and so that's when you would want to go and retape the catheter. But whenever I tape, I like to tape up, so I wrap up the leg. I only have about a quarter to a half showing of the tape underneath it, and then courtesy tab on the end of that as well. The second piece, I personally call a bra strap piece because it supports this first piece of tape. You're gonna wedge it underneath, sticky side down, up to that piece, the first piece of tape. And then you're gonna wrap it around. Again, I pull it taut on the bottom and then lay it gently over the top. I don't wanna cover right here because I'm gonna put a T-port on there. And so I'm gonna lay it gently there, making sure that I can see the tip of here so it doesn't get stuck with the T-port. And again, I'm going to wrap up the leg. The reason why we wrap up the leg is because if you do it all stacked on top of each other, it's gonna do something that we call braceleting, and it's gonna just slide right off the leg, especially for those dogs like Shih Tzus and Bulldogs who have those thicker legs up here and the smaller ones down here. And so we want to do what we can to give it extra surface to stick. We had shaved on this patient all the way around. You don't necessarily have to, but if you do, you want to give good margins. So I would shave at least the top half and leave here. If they have feathers on the bottom, I would shave the feathers. All right, so now that I have my first two pieces on, I'm going to place the T-port on. So this one already has a syringe attached. We make sure to pre-flush it. What I'm going to do is take this plastic piece off. I'm gonna hold off the vessel right here to try and stop it from bleeding. The other thing you can do that I like to do if I know that I might not be good at it for like larger dogs is I will take a piece of gauze, I will wedge it up underneath the IV catheter so that guards any blood that drips down and puts it on the gauze versus our tape, because we wanna keep that as clean as possible to reduce issues with bacteria and infections. So I'm gonna hold off the vessel the best I can here. I'm gonna pull off this adapter, drop it, and then put the T-port on. You can have the T-port facing either way. I personally like to have it facing the inside. So I will hold this tight, twist it if I need to adjust it, and then just make sure it's on firm so that it doesn't leak out between the connections. I like to have it this way so that I can horseshoe the other side out to the outside, which gives it easier access, especially if you have a dog that's fractious and likes to bite. It means you don't have to reach in right under their face. You can come from the side. So the next piece is a piece that's gonna hold the T-port in place. So I'm going to take this thin half inch piece, I'm gonna twist it in the center. I'm gonna have sticky side up, place it underneath this first part of the T-port. I'm gonna wrap it so that it goes across this connection and holds it firm. And then I'm gonna take the other one and crisscross to the other side. Both of these also have a courtesy tab on them. And then the last thing I do before I tape this down is I like to flush and make sure that I can feel it go through the vessel and that I don't have any concerns. And so I'm going to take this last piece of tape, I'm going to horseshoe it. And so we have a clamp here that you can put it in two different locations. You can have it up top here or down below here. My strong preference is that you put it down below here because it gives you more room to, again, wrap up the leg so that it doesn't create so much bulk here that it creates weight and pulls it out. So I like to have a courtesy tab. I wrap it again around the end of the T-port, being careful not to cover this connection right here so that we can easily put an adapter or syringe on it. I'm again going to horseshoe it so that it's on the other side of this injection port. And I'm going to wrap it around. Again, you can pull a little taut down here and then I lay it down gently. And then after that, I just keep laying it gently and I just wrap it up. And again, courtesy tab. All right, so then the last thing I'm gonna do, I flush one more time to make sure nothing crazy happened. Feels good, so I'm going to clamp the IV catheter. So I'm gonna get a new maladapter. I'm gonna separate the pieces, take this piece, it's gonna insert into the end here. So since I clamped it, I'm okay to remove my syringe, and I'm gonna put this on here. And then you have the catheter taped in. I also try to wear gloves for all of our patients when I can in emergent situations. It's not always so easy, especially if it also gets bloody. Sometimes I have to take them off. But for most patients, you want to try to wear gloves to keep it as clean as possible. So next we're going to be hooking up the fluids. And so first we want to make sure that the fluid line is primed completely with fluids. Make sure there's no large air bubbles. Little tiny ones are okay. But we want to make sure that there's no large air bubbles within the line. And then I'm going to disconnect this blue piece, take off this maladapter, and hook in the extension set. So this should insert in and then this screws on. So you want to make sure that's on there snug so that it doesn't just pop off. Then next we're going to do a stress loop. And so what we want to do is create something so that if they are pulling on the line, it doesn't pull on the catheter as well. And so we're going to again do a little horseshoe loop. And sometimes it likes to go its own way. So you can do it however it loops. So as long as it loops this way, or if it wants to loop this way, you can do it that way. So we're gonna have a piece of tape. Again, we're gonna courtesy tab it. We're gonna loop it. I'm gonna tape it right down here. And again, I wanna tape it up higher because I don't wanna add weight down here to the catheter. So I'm gonna do it again. I'm gonna wrap this around so that it connects to the other side. And then I'm going to tape it down up high here and wrap it around his leg. And again, I wrap it up the leg a little bit and courtesy tab at the end. And then once you're done with that, you can unclamp and start the fluids.